Right. Let us remember all mu'mineen wal mu'minat who are ill and sick with five times Amma Yujib. We'll pray all together. Allahumma salli ala Muhammadin wa ali Muhammad. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Amma Yujibul Mudhtar Ida da'ahu wa yakshifu su. Amma Yujibul Mudhtar Ida da'ahu wa yakshifu su. Amma Yujibul Mudhtar Ida da'ahu wa yakshifu su. أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء أما يجيب المضطر إذا دعاه ويكشف السوء سورة المباركة الفاتحة شفاء مرضى أعوذ بالله من الشيطان اللعين الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله العلي العظيم حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل نعم المولى ونعم النصير نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشكره ونصلي ونسلم على حبيب إله العالمين حافظ سره ومبلغ رسالته الرسول المسدد المصطفى الأمجد المحمود الأحمد أبي القاسم محمد وبآله الطيبين الطاهرين المعصومين صلوات الله عليهم أجمعين ولعنة الله على أعدائهم ومنكر فضائلهم وغاصب حقوقهم من الأولين والآخرين من الآن إلى قيام يوم الدين أما بعد فقد قال الله تبارك وتعالى في كتابه المجيد وكلامه الكريم وقوله الحق بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا عرضنا الأمانة على السماوات والأرض والجبال فأبينا أن يحملنها وأشفقنا منها وحملها الإنسان إنه كان ظلوما جهولا آمنا بالله وصدق الله العلي العظيم صلوا على محمد وآل محمد Indeed, it is a joyous occasion when one wants to pay tribute to this holy personality, to this illustrious lady. One thinks, where shall he start and where he ends? If we start by discussing her name, then Zainab itself, and you heard the qasidas right now, Zainab, the name itself shows that every inch of this personality shows the image of her father. Every inch of her personality shows the photo or the image of her father, Amirul Mu'mineen. We mentioned this in Khutbah Jumu'ah, that Zainab consists of two words, which is Zain and Ab. Zainab means the beauty of her father. And when it is said the beauty of her father, what has she taken from her father? She has taken that eloquence. She has taken that accent. She has taken that fluency. She has taken that language, that fasahat and balagat of Amirul Mu'mineen. Imagine that this holy lady, after the event of Karbala, now we might discuss some incidents which took place in Karbala, and I know tonight is a happy occasion, but forgive me, and you have to bear with me, that there are some personalities, their situation or their personalities are such, they are such by themselves, that if you mention their fazail also, the incidence of masaib, it comes by itself. Because of them, they've witnessed so much. They had to go through so much. Like herself, from her titles, one of her titles is Ummul Masaib, which means the mother of the tribulations, or the mother of trials, or the mother of tests. So if you take her name Zainab, every inch of her personality is Amirul Mumineen. Because when she spoke, when after the event of Karbala, when she reached at the high streets of Kufa, when she was brought at the court of Ibn Ziyad, La'natullah alayh, and when she started delivering that sermon, personalities like Abdullah bin Afif, who was the companion of Amirul Mumineen, who lost one eye of his in the battle of Siffin and the other eye in the battle of Jamal. He could not see. He was completely blind. But when he heard the accent of the khutbah of Zainab alayha salam, and when he heard that sermon, that beautiful, eloquent sermon of Bibi Zainab alayha salam, he started posing a question to the people who were surrounded him. He said that, has Ali revived? They said, no. He said that, then if Ali has not revived, then this is the day of judgment. He says, why? He says, on the 21st night of the holy month of Ramadan, when I went to bid farewell Amirul Mumineen, when he was on his deathbed, and I told Amirul Mumineen that, oh Ali, you are Waliye Amr, and you have got that power which you are blessed by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You can show miracles. You have got miraculous powers. Can you return my eyesight, which I have lost in these two battles? Amirul Mumineen said that, oh Abdullah bin Afif, if you want me to return your eyesight, I will, surely. We are blessed with that power. We are given that miraculous power by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But do know, what if I return your eyesight back? A time comes, you pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that I wish this eyesight, I would have not been restored again. I wish I would have not got my eyesight back. If a time comes, you pray this to Allah. Then Abdullah bin Afif said that, no, I don't want this eyesight. He says, now I have remembered why Amirul Mumineen told me. And I could figure out that because I will hear this khutbah, because she was told that this is the daughter of Amirul Mumineen. This is Zainab. Now when she was born, Rasulullah was not in town. She was born on the fifth day of the fifth month of the fifth year after Hijrah. Because when we take a date, we take the day, the month, and the year. So she, coincidentally, five is a lucky number, panjatan panch. When we teach our children, starting saying Allah ek panjatan panch, we say five is a lucky number. She was born on the fifth day of the fifth month. Jamadul Awwal is fifth month, and five after Hijrah. It's easy to remember. Yeah. Rasulullah was not in town. And when he was informed, when Zahra alayha salam took her child in her arms, she hands over to Amirul Mumineen. And she says to Ali alayhi salam that, Ya Ali, name her. Ali alayhi salam says, I cannot take precedence and preference. I cannot give priority to myself over Rasulullah. I'll have to wait for the messenger of Allah. When Rasulullah came over, it is said that the last person to meet before his journey was Zahra. Every journey of his. And the first person to meet whenever he entered Medina was Zahra. So the first person he would meet is Zahra. And we all know that the house which they lived in, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless us, to go to Medina and perform the ziyarah of Masjid al-Nabawi. And you will witness that houses, that room of Zahra alayha salam, all the houses which they lived in, from inside they were commanded that the door should be closed. Only the house of Ali alayhi salam, the door should be open. And now this itself, it says, it goes without saying, that they were tahir. Who is, otherwise, najis people are not allowed to enter the masjid. So there's nothing like najasat in Ahlul Bayt. Quran says, إِنَّمَا يُرِيدُ اللَّهُ لِيُضْحِبَ عَنْكُمُ الرِّجْسَ أَهْلَ الْبَيْتِ وَيُطَهِّرَكُمْ تَطْهِيرًا. We have purified them with thorough purification. So when Rasulullah comes in, he goes to the house of Zahra. And then when the child was handed to his hands, to his arms, And then Rasulullah says, I cannot take precedence over Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I will wait for the command of Allah. Thus, the name of Zainab was given to her by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Jibreel Amin revealed, and he came with this wahi, with this divine message, that, oh, Ya Rasulullah, Allah commands that she should be named Zainab, the beauty of her father. Thus, she was named Zainab. Another quality of hers is Saniya Zahra, which means the replica of Zahra. She was completely, you can see the spirits shifting from generation to another generation. She was completely like Zahra. Completely like Zahra. Thus, she was called Saniya Zahra. And that is why a poet says in his words that Fakhre Maryam Janabe Zahra. If you want to see the replica of Maryam, is Janabe Zahra. Although Janabe Zahra's maqam is higher than Maryam. But now here poet says because Maryam came first, age-wise, then Zahra came. Thus the poet says in Urdu, he says, Fakhre Maryam Janabe Zahra. Fakhre Zahra Janabe Zainab. Janabe Zainab ke baad, Janabe Zainab, Janabe Zainab, Janabe Zainab. What does it mean? It means that the replica of Maryam is Zahra, and the replica of Zahra is Zainab. But then the poet, he waits, and he can't continue. He can't see any other personality other than Zainab. He can't see any other personality to inherit Zainab. He says, after Zainab, 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 Zainab. There is no Saniya Zainab. There is Saniya Zahra, but there is no Saniya Zainab. This is the maqam of Zainab. And then if you move forward, you will find another quality of hers is Sharikatul Husayn. It is very important for us to know this quality. Why? Because our kids, every Saturday they go to that madrasa, which we have named after this holy lady. And I understand this madrasa was reopened on this holy day, on the birth anniversary of this holy personality, on the 5th of Jamadul Awwal. It was established 1996. So it's very important for us to know, because our children, every Saturday, they wake up early in the morning, they carry their bags. Some they sit in the van, they go in the cars, and they should be told. We as parents, we should tell our children, we should instill these values that, oh my son, oh my daughter, when you are going to this workshop, do you know it is named after which personality? It is named after this personality whose wilada we are celebrating tonight. Sharikatul Hussein, it means, what does it mean? It means the partner of Hussein. See, the mission and the goal of Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, we all know what was his goal. It was to save Islam. Zainab was part and parcel of the task of the goal of Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam. She, you see, nowadays it's very easy. Right now, if I post something in Facebook, the whole world will know what I have posted because of social media. You've got Twitter, you've got Facebook, you've got everything. What has happened in that part of the world, everybody knows. Yeah, but 14 centuries ago, you won't know what transpired. Let alone 14 centuries ago, a generation ago, even a generation ago, 30 years or 25 years ago, yeah, in those times also people would still write letters. Nowadays, who is writing letters? All are emailing nowadays. Because people say it, our elders would say, that we would remember that people would say that there'll come a time that you just, in a click of a button, you could send your letter. That now the time has come. That we just click that send and the letter goes. Yeah, but it was different times that people were not aware what is happening in other part of the world. Nowadays, due to Facebook, social, all this social media, Twitter, even those people whom you are not aware, perhaps you know them, but you don't know what happened in that part of the world. You'll come to know the news. Maybe you just enter in WhatsApp and you see their display picture or their status. You'll come to know that these two are engaged. I'm not talking of Lester. But perhaps you know some people engaged to be married. Or sometimes you'll see the photographs of the fiance and the fiance. Both of them, they are together. Okay, muta is recited. But then there is a status there. You are a perfect person for me. You are perfect for me. You are a perfect person. although this statement is not right, nobody is perfect. Yeah, what we believe is perfect are only a'immas. Masooms are only perfect. Rasulullah is only perfect, isn't it? But now you'll find this statements and this status, and you'll come to know these are engaged now, yeah, due to social media. But there was a time 14 centuries ago, what happened in Karbala? Hussein ibn Ali alayhi salam, when he gave his head, when he sacrificed himself, how would people know that who sacrificed in Karbala? And what was the mission of Hussein? It was through Zainab that people knew. And she said, Zalim ke mazalim se na ghabraungi bhaiya. Zalim ke mazalim se na ghabraungi bhaiya. Ghar ghar tere peygham ko pahunchaungi bhaiya. Just like Zahra, if Zahra took the message of Ghadir, she went to every door, she knocked, and she said that, weren't you present in the Maidan of Ghadir? Didn't you hear Rasul saying, Man kuntu mawlahu fahadha aliyun mawla? Zahra did that. Yeah, Zainab did the same. She was the bearer of the message. She was the carrier of the message. She carried the message of Imam Hussein alayhi salam, of the mission of Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Thus she was Sharikatul Hussein, which means the partner of Hussein. Now, if you recite Ziyarat Nahiya, the Ziyarat of Imam Zamana, Ajallahu Ta'ala Farajahu Sharif, there is a beautiful ziyarah of Imam Zamana for Imam Hussein alayhi salam. Imam Hussein has got many ziyarats. Nahiya, which means Imam Zamana is lamenting, he's weeping for Imam Hussein. In that ziyarah, there is a word, there is a sentence for Imam Hussein. Imam Zamana says, Kad ajabat malaikatu min sabrika ya Aba Abdillah. The malaika are astonished. You left, O Aba Abdillah, Imam Zamana says to his grandfather Hussein. He says that you left astonishing the malaikas, the angels, to see your passions, O Hussein. So if we also recite Ziyarat Nahiya, then we should also think about Zainab also, because she was part and parcel of Hussein. She was the partner of Hussein. We should say, Kad ajabat malaikatu bi sabriki min sabriki ya Zainab. The malaika were amazed to see your sabr, O Zainab. Your patience, O Zainab. Why? Because if I give you examples of Zainab, you will be amazed that this holy lady, let alone wajibat, she did not leave mustahabbat. She did not leave namazul layl, salatul layl. She did not leave 51 rakat salah. All the nawafil she was reciting, until Imam Sajjad says that I witnessed myself. I saw my aunt Zainab, that now she's praying while sitting. And I asked her, she said that the food, the amount of food, the quantity of the food is coming is so little that I'm sacrificing the food to the young ones and I'm having very little, now I've become weak. Imagine on the day of Ashura, Imam Hussein tells her, the Imam of the time tells her, La tansini fi salatil layl. The Imam of the time tells you, do not forget me. He says to a ghere masuma, do not forget me in salatil layl. Imam Zamana tells somebody amongst us that do not forget me in Salat al-Layl. It's a great thing that Zainab is being told by the Imam of the time. This was Zainab alayha salam. Now you'll find all these qualities. The whole event, I should say, the whole tragedy of Karbala revolves around these two personalities, Zainab and Hussein. Zainab and Hussein. And all these titles of Zainab, it has got relation with the imams, with a'immas, with ma'asums. Or you'll find she's also called alima. What does it mean? She was completely like her father, even in knowledge. She was alima. And when was she given this title? As soon as she delivered the sermon. And when she delivered the sermon, she left Ibn Ziyad astonished. When she delivered the sermon in the courtroom of Ibn Ziyad said, but you are a poetess, and your father was a poet. She replied, he was expecting that Zainab will be quiet, but Zainab replied, if I was a poet, but then would I remain still a poetess? If I was a poetess, would I remain still a poetess after going through all this? that I saw 17 of my family members unburied, lying on the ground. After seeing everything this, would I still remain a poetess? After all, you all know, for majlis also you need preparation. Who wrote for her this sermon? When did she prepare? This was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Imam Sajjad bears witness about that. When she finished her sermon, Imam Sajjad says, "Anti alimatun ghayri mu'allima, anti fahima ghayri mufahima." You are that alima, you are that scholar, you are that learned personality. No one has taught you, but it has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You are fahima, you have got that understanding that no one has instilled in your mind. It has come through Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It has come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she was, because she was Zainab, she was like her father, the way Amirul Mumineen was alim. Alim is a very small word for Amirul Mumineen. Abundance of knowledge. That Salman al-Farsi says, "I witnessed Amirul Mumineen going to the well. He's talking to the well. And I was amazed. I said that, Ya Ali, what are you doing there?" Ali says, "I've got so much knowledge. It is saturated, accumulated in my chest. Nobody is ready to come and take this knowledge. Now I'm going in the well and I'm talking with the well. I'm talking to the well. Ali alayhi salam, I'm giving my knowledge to the well." This is the daughter of that Ali. This is the daughter of that Ali. And there is one quality of Zainab, which is Aqila. What does Aqila mean? Aqila means most intelligent. But this title is Aqila Bani Hashim. The most intelligent of the clan of Bani Hashim. Now if we are celebrating birth anniversary of this holy personality, let us pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with the wasila of this holy lady, that may Allah give us opportunity to go to perform her ziyara in Sham. One, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq to listen to this, to the lessons of her life, the lessons derived from her life. But then we pray that may Allah give us tawfiq to implement these lessons, these morals in our lives, to understand, to have tawfiq, to understand her, to comprehend her, because it's very hard to comprehend, or it's very hard to implement these lessons. If we want to know that, how can I be aqil? How can I be intelligent? If she was aqila, how can I be intelligent? I want to be intelligent. It's extremely important to have wisdom, because Allah says in Quran, يُؤْتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَى وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. Hikmat means wisdom. And Zainab had that wisdom because she was Aqila Bani Hashim. Quran says, Allah gives wisdom to whoever he wants. يُؤْتِ الْحِكْمَةَ مَنْ يَشَى وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ. And whoever God gets wisdom, فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. He has got khair kathir. He has got good in abundance. So I need wisdom. I want intelligence. How can I get intelligence? I'll pray to Allah with the wasila of this holy personality. Give me wisdom. But how will I get wisdom? How will I get intelligence? Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam says, that there are four signs of intelligence. Yeah, of aqil person. The first sign is that he will obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He will be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. See, after the battle of Badr, when the bodies were brought of polytheists, of mushrikeen, to Rasulullah, Rasulullah spoke to them. Rasulullah started speaking to them. He said that, "Do you witness now? Did you see the promise of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Can you remember now what I told is the truth?" So Umar was seated there, the second caliph. He said that, "Atukhatibul mauta, Ya Rasulullah, are you speaking to the dead?" Rasulullah replies to Umar, "Sahi ibn al-Khattab, be quiet, O the son of Khattab. They can hear more than you hear." What does Rasulullah say to them? Rasulullah says that, "Have you witnessed? Have you seen the promise of Allah? And do you believe now what I was saying?" Much later, in the time of Amirul Mumineen, we've got same incident that after the Battle of Jamal, Amirul Mumineen speaks to Ka'b ibn Sur and to Talha ibn Zubair. These are personalities who fought against Amirul Mumineen. And Imam Ali, now here is Amirul Mumineen. There was Rasulullah. Here Ali alayhi salam says to his companions, "Make him sit." And they were made to sit.
Rasul Ali alayhi salam speaks to them. Ali alayhi salam speaks to Ka'b ibn Sur. Ka'b was a qazi appointed by Umar, by second caliph. And he gave the fatwa to fight against Amirul Mu'minin. They were all together. They fought Aisha, Talha, Zubair, Ka'b ibn Sur. He was attracted and tempted by Aisha with his brothers, with his son. And they were all killed in the Battle of Jamal. And when they were killed in the Battle of Jamal, at that time when their bodies were brought, Amirul Mu'minin commanded that the deceased body of Ka'b should be kept sitting. And Amirul Mu'minin is conversing to him. Amirul Mu'minin is saying that, did you witness? Did you believe what I said was truth? Allah fulfilled my promise. Did Allah fulfill your promise? Did you see what's happening to you? Even Rasulullah, when Umar said to Rasulullah, Umar said, how do you speak to the dead? Rasulullah said that, no, they can see, they can hear more than you hear. The angels have brought azab for them. They are just waiting for me to move. Yeah. So the first thing is to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wherever you are. These people, they didn't obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yeah. To be obedient to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ita'at khuda, the second sign of an intellectual person. What is the second sign? The second sign is that he should have that understanding that time goes very quickly. Time goes very quickly. See, we have entered to 2015. February is about to end. Today is 24th of February. Yeah. Soon it will come June, half of the year, 2015 has gone. A wise person is that person who knows time goes very quickly. The Holy Prophet is quoted to have said that daily an angel, he screams from the heavens, daily. He says to the people over 20s that work hard, the people over 30s, they are being told, what are they being told? That do not be heedless and do not be carried away with material things. Those who are over 40s, they are being told, whatever you have gathered, you have to give hisab. Those who are over 50s, they are being told that a warner has come to you. Over 60, they are being told that soon you will reap what you have sowed. There is no time to sow now. Over 70s, they are being told that reply the call. Over 80s, they are being told, time is up. Time is up. See, somebody told me something very important, that if you live over 63, this is a bonus. Why? Because Rasulullah himself lived for 63 years. So if you are blessed more than 63, itself is a bonus. It's a bonus which Allah has given you. The best of the creature, Rasulullah, lived for 63 years. So the second quality of an aqil, of an intellectual person, is he knows that time goes very quickly. What is the third sign? The third sign is that he will know my original house, my real house, is Qabr. It is so good. Those people, and even in the past, they had already bought their land of Qabr. And whenever they go to Qabristan, they see their land. Why is it mustahab? When you go to Karbala, you bring kafan with you. When you bring that kafan, just keep in the cupboard? No, look at it. When you go to Qabristan, look at that piece of land that you will be buried there. Yeah? Because you should know that that is your original place. That is your original place. In the time of Nabi Isa alayhi salam, Isa, in the time of summer, it was very hot. He went up on the mountains. He saw a worshipper. He was worshipping. And then Isa asked him that, why are you worshipping here on top of the mountain? Don't you have a house? He says, I have not created a shed for myself. Why? He says, one of the prophet told me that I will live very short. My life is not very long. Thus, why should I create an accommodation for myself? So Isa tells him that, how long will you live? What did he tell you? He said that I live only 700 years. 700 years? He says, yes. Now we might laugh. 700 years. Now in those times, people were living for 3,000 years, for 1,000 years. Yeah? Nuh lived for 2,500 years. 950 years only he did tabligh. Thus 700 years, he says, it's very little for me. It's not much time. Why should I create for myself a shed? Thus I'm doing ibadat here, he says. There's no need to create a house for myself, to build a house for myself. So Isa tells him, interestingly, that shall I tell you something which will amaze you? He says, yes. In the time of Akhiru Zaman, people's lives will be so short, it will be less than 100 years, but their hopes will be so high, like that of 1,000 years. They will build for themselves great palaces, as if they are going to live for 1,000 years. So this Abid says, if I would have been in their place, whole life I would have done sajda. I would have spent my whole life in prostrating Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then he advises Isa, he says, go to their cave. Okay, go to that cave. Inside that cave, you'll see a grave. Go and see that grave. Just go and see, do ziyarah of that grave. Isa says, I went to that grave. I saw on top of that grave, it was written that this, I was a certain king. I lived for 1,000 years. I built 1,000 cities. I married 1,000 spinsters. I defeated 1,000 armies. But this is my situation today. Oh, wise people, take lesson from me. Oh, wise people, take lesson from me. So this is the third quality. And what is the fourth quality? The fourth quality of an aqil, of an intellectual person, is he should know that shaitan is my original enemy. Shaitan is my enemy. Sometimes it happens, exchange of words. We are not ready to forgive each other. We don't forget. Sometimes you'll find people say, I can forgive, but I can't forget. It's hard. No, forget. Forget Mu'mineen's faults. It happens, shortcomings. It happens, misunderstandings, exchange of words. Forget everything. You don't want to take any. What will you take from this world? You'll be buried with empty-handed. You'll go with one shroud. Changiz said that when you bury me, he was a great king. He said, when you bury me, leave my head, take out the hands from my coffin, keep it open. Keep it outside so that people should take lesson that I've gone empty-handed. Whatever I earned, I'm living here. Whatever I earned. Shaitan is your real enemy. Mu'mineen are not your enemies. We keep grudge for other Mu'mineen and Mu'minat perhaps. Somebody said this. You have heard. Give good intention for him. Do husnazan and give good intention for him. Yeah, but do not be negative thinking. So what happens is, shaitan is your real enemy. And that is why it is said, when the Holy Prophet of Islam, Hazrat Muhammad Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was appointed as a prophet, as a final messenger, Rasulullah, the all other Satans, the army of Satan, they went to Iblis and they said that, oh Iblis, Muhammad is already appointed as a messenger. What shall we do? The leader of Satans, Iblis, said, do not worry. Why are you worried? If they won't be polytheists, they won't be worshipping idols, but they'll have hubba dunya in their hearts. They'll be having love for this world. Since they'll be having love for this world, you can attract them through these three things. You can astray them through these three things. The first thing Iblis says to his army, to other Satans, he says the first thing is that they should not pay the religious dues. First thing, and encourage them that they should not pay their religious dues. The second thing is that they should not pay. They should earn through haram way, and after they've earned through haram way, they should use their money in haram way. They should earn through haram and use through haram. Yeah, this is three things Iblis says to his army, that you astray people in this way. Shaitan is our real enemy. These are four qualities, four signs of a true, of an aqil person, of an intellectual person. If we really want to be aqil, the way Zainab is aqila bani Hashim, we pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that may Allah give us tawfiq to act and implement upon these qualities. If we are the followers of Zainab alayhi salam, please recite a salawat. Bari digar baba se balan salawat padhiye. Muhtaram Sameen, Bibi Zainab alayha salam ki zindagi se bahut kuch cheez milne ko hai, bahut milta hai hame, hum bahut kuch hasil kar sakte hain. Aur unme se main aaj subah se ghor karta tha कि इस बीबी की जिंदगी से हम क्या कुछ हासिल कर सकते हैं। सबसे बड़ी चीज वो है हिम्मत ज़ैनब। ज़ैनब की जिंदगी से हमें हिम्मत हासिल करने को मिलता है। ज़ैनब की हिम्मत, हिम्मत बहुत बड़ी चीज है वाकयन। और हिम्मत जो है ये फकत मर्द से कन्फाइन नहीं है, फकत मर्द से महदूद नहीं है। इंटरेस्टिंगली उलमाए किराम कहते हैं कि हिम्मत औरतों से भी मिल सकता है ना, ये महदूद नहीं है फकत मर्दों से या फकत औरतों से या बच्चों से, बच्चों या बड़ों से, बच्चों से भी हिम्मत हासिल हो सकती है। हिम्मत यानी क्या, यानी इंसान जब देखे एक चीज बुरा है, एक चीज बुरी है, वो एक फर्म स्टेप ले, ही शुड परफॉर्म द राइट थिंग, स्पीक द राइट थिंग, जो भी उनको बोलना है वो बोले, उसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। हिम्मत करे, ये न सोचे कि वो क्या कहेगा, वो क्या सोचेगा, इसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। आप देखिए तारीख में, मैं फकत जल्दी आपके सामने पेश करूं, देखिए उलमाए कितने ऐसे शख्सियात हमें मिलते हैं, जैसे कि मूसा की वालिदा, खुदा ने उनको इल्हाम दिया, हिम्मत के साथ उन्होंने बच्चे को नदी पे रखा, नहर पे रखा, ये हिम्मत थी मूसा की वालिदा की। या ईसा की वालिदा, ईसा की वालिदा मरियम ने भी हिम्मत के साथ आगे आई बनी इसराइल के पास, हालांकि वो सोचती थी कि ये लोग क्या कहेंगे, फिर भी हिम्मत के साथ आ गई, इसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। या आसिया, उन्होंने कहा कि नहीं, मैंने दुआ करती है कि खुदाया मेरे लिए घर बनाओ जन्नत में, फिरौन मुझे मार डाले तो भले मारे, मुझे कोई मुश्किल नहीं है, इसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। यानी क्या, यानी इंसान सच बात कहे, एक कदम उठाए आगे, और नहीं न सोचे कि ये क्या कहेगा, वो क्या बोलेगा, मैं जो भी करता हूं अल्लाह के लिए करता हूं। ऐसे कभी कभार ऐसा मकाम भी आता है, ऐसा सिचुएशन आता है इंसान पर कि नमाज पढ़ने का वक्त आ गया है ना, या तो वो एक फ्लाइट पे बोर्ड हुआ, एयरक्राफ्ट पे, बहुत लंबी फ्लाइट है, मिसाल के तौर पर अमेरिका की फ्लाइट है, वो जानते हैं कि मैं जब वहां पे पहुंचूंगा 10 घंटे के बाद नमाज कजा हो जाएगी, वो एयरक्राफ्ट के अंदर भी नमाज पढ़े, कोई बात नहीं, एयर होस्टेस क्या सोचेंगे, वो लोग क्या कहेंगे, किबला पूछो और कहो और पढ़ो नमाज, चाहे इट इज इन द एयरपोर्ट, इफ इट इज इन द एयरक्राफ्ट, इट इज इन द पार्क, इट इज इन अ वर्क प्लेस, इट इज इन स्कूल, इट इज इन कॉलेज, जहां पे भी इंसान सच काम करे फकत खुदा के लिए, इसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। या तो आप देखिए जंगे ओहद में, जंगे ओहद में मुसलमान, आप जानते हैं मुसलमानों के साथ क्या हुआ, लेकिन हिम्मत अमीरुल मोमिनीन आप देखें कि 60 अमीरुल मोमिनीन जख्मी किए गए, मजरूह हो गए, और अमीरुल मोमिनीन ने 60 जख्म लिए, रसूलुल्लाह को अमीरुल मोमिनीन ने बचाया, और उसके बाद अबू सुफियान ने फायदा उठाया सिचुएशन का। अबू सुफियान ने क्या किया, अबू सुफियान ने कहा कि अब क्योंकि मुसलमान हार गए जंगे ओहद के बाद, हम दोबारा जाए और उनको उनके ऊपर हमला करें। जब यह खबर पहुंची मदीने में तो रसूल आ गए मुसलमानों के पास, रसूल ने मुसलमानों से कहा कि चलो हम हिम्मत के साथ जाए और दोबारा लड़े, कौन हमारे साथ आमादा है जंग में जाने के लिए। तो कुछ लोग जो मजरूह हो गए थे उन लोगों ने कहा कि हम आमादा है, रसूल से कहने लगे हम आमादा है आपके साथ आने के लिए। उस वक्त कुरान मजीद ने उनका तज़किरा किया और कुरान मजीद ने कहा उनके बारे में, कुरान ने कहा कि इन्होंने ईमान, उनका ईमान बढ़ा, फजादहुम ईमाना, उनका ईमान बढ़ा, फकाल हस्बुनल्लाह, उन लोगों ने कहा कि खुदा हमारे लिए काफी है, हिम्मत के साथ वो गए लड़ने के लिए, इसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। और इंसान एक कदम उठाता है, खुदा उनको 10 कदम में मदद करता है, इसको कहते हैं हिम्मत। ये फकत कन्फाइन नहीं है बच्चों के साथ फकत, है ना, हम या बड़ों के साथ, कभी कभार बच्चा भी हिम्मत करता है और आगे बढ़ता है। हम जब हौजा में थे ना तो हमारे उस्ताद हिम्मत की हिम्मत का दर्स दिया करते थे, दर्स अखलाक में, और फकत 5 मिनट बाकी था ये दर्स खत्म होने को, तो एक लड़का आ गया, वारिद हुआ, तो उस वक्त उस्ताद ने कहा कि ये भी हिम्मत बुलंद रखता है, आप होते तो आप कहते कि अब कौन जाए दर्स में, इन्होंने भी हिम्मत के साथ आ गया, 5 मिनट बाकी है फिर भी वो क्लास में आया, है ना। रिवायत में है अल मरउ यतीरु बिहिम्मते, इंसान हिम्मत के साथ उड़ सकता है, आगे जा सकता है। या तो अमीरुल मोमिनीन अली इब्न अबी तालिब सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि ने जो बलागा में फरमाते हैं, इंसान की कीमत उनकी हिम्मत है, कदरुल मरु बेहिम्मत है। इंसान हम जानना चाहते ना कि हमारी कद्र क्या है, या तो हमारी कद्र इल्म है या तो हमारी कद्र हमारी हिम्मत है। हिम्मत करके इंसान आगे बढ़े। और ज़ैनब की जिंदगी में हमें हिम्मत नजर आता है। और वो कैसे? फकत तीन एग्जाम्पल्स आपकी ज़हमत को तमाम करूं। आप देखिए, आशूर के दिन ज़ैनब अलैहिस्सलाम तिल्ले ज़ैनबिया के ऊपर है और अपने भाई को देखती है। ये बाहिम्मत थी, ये मोहतरमा, ये शहजादी बाहिम्मत थी। या तो जब कूफा पहुंचती है तो इब्ने ज़ियाद मलऊन ने कहा कि ये औरत कौन है, तो तीन मर्तबा इब्ने ज़ियाद ने पूछा, ज़ैनब ने जवाब नहीं दिया। हत्ता एक कनीज ने कहा कि ये अमीरुल मोमिनीन की बेटी ज़ैनब है। उसके बाद इब्ने ज़ियाद ने मुखातिब होकर ज़ैनब से कहा कि आया तुमने देखा कि तुम्हें किस तरीके से जलील किया गया, तुम्हारे मर्दों को मारा गया और तुम्हारी और ख्वातीन को असीर किया गया, कैदी बनाया गया और यहां पे लाए गए सब तुम, खुदा ने तुम्हें जलील किया। ज़ैनब ने जवाब में यह कहा कि जलील हम नहीं किए गए, खुदा ने तुम्हें जलील किया। ज़ैनब ने जवाब में यह कहा। फिर ज़ैनब ने कहा कि हमें जिल्लत नहीं मिली, हमें तो चुना गया कि हम मोहम्मद के इतरत में से हमें चुना गया, कि हम मोहम्मद की आल में से हमें रखा गया और खुदा ने हमारे लिए कहा कि हम हर रिज से हर नजासत से दूर है। ज़ैनब ने यह जवाब दिया। हमने अर्ज किया ना आपकी खिदमत में कि बच्चों में भी कभी कभार यह चीज पाई जाती है, हिम्मत। आशूर के दिन इमाम हसन के एक फर्जंद थे जिसका नाम था अब्दुल्ला। रिवायत कहती है कि वो फकत 10 साल के थे, छोटे थे। ज़ैनब ने उनको गले लगाया था तिल्ले ज़ैनबिया में, लेकिन हिम्मत देखिए उस छोटे बच्चे की। इमाम हसन के फर्जंद थे, उनके रगों में हसन का खून था, मोहम्मद उनके रगों में हसन का खून दौड़ रहा था। हिम्मत देखिए, जब ज़ैनब परेशान हुई तो ये छोटे शहजादे गए कत्लगाह तक और उन्होंने कहा कि मैं मेरे चचा को बचाने आया, तुम उसको मत मारो, ये अली और फातिमा के लाल है। उनके पास तलवार नहीं थी, उन्होंने दिफा की। हजरत अब्दुल्ला ने फकत 10 साल के थे लेकिन हिम्मत देखिए, दिफा की। तलवार नहीं थी उनके पास लेकिन हाथों के जरिए उन्होंने लड़ा, दिफा किया हाथों के जरिए। हत्ता जब उन्होंने हाथ को फैलाए तो उनके हाथ को काटे गए, उनके शाने को काटे गए। हिम्मत देखिए। तो यह सारे मिसाल हमारे सामने हैं, ये सारे इंसिडेंट्स हमारे सामने हैं। आज अगर हम ज़ैनब की विलादत मनाते हैं तो हमने क्या दर्स हासिल किया बीबी ज़ैनब की जिंदगी से, ये हम अपने आप से सवाल करें। हम अगर मजलिस सुनते हैं तो हमने क्या हासिल किया? अगर आपने एक जुमला हासिल किया और हासिल करने के बाद आपने अप्लाई किया, इंप्लीमेंट किया, तो यकीन जाने ये मजलिस बेनिफिशियल है। मैं बारहा अर्ज करता हूं, अगर मैं चाहता तो मजलिस पूरा फजीलत पढ़ता और आप यहां पे सब वाह वाह करते। ऐसी बात भी नहीं है कि फजीलत न बयान की जाए, लेकिन फजीलत के साथ अखलाक भी जरूरी है ना, अखलाक जरूरी है ना। ये रूह का खाना है, जैसे खाना मादियात के लिए जरूरी है, मानवियात के लिए ये नसीहतें जरूरी है, मखसूसन ज़ैनब जैसी शख्सियत की जिंदगी से। आए हम सब मिलके खुदावंद करीम के पास दुआ करके, पालने वाले तुझे वास्ता देते उस बीबी का कि दर बदर उन्हें फिराया गया, खुदाया आज वही शहर में जहां पे उनका रोजा है, खुदाया उसी शहर में अमन अमान कायम कर। मोमिनीन सीरिया में जाया करते थे, ज़ैनब की जियारत पढ़ा करते थे, लेकिन आज कोई नहीं जा सकता, आज अमनियत नहीं है उस शहर में। खुदाया उस मुल्क में अमनियत कायम कर। खुदाया इस्लामी ममालिक में, जिस ममालिक में अमनियत नहीं है, मखसूसन इराक, अफगानिस्तान, पाकिस्तान, बहरीन, उन सारे ममालिक में अमन अमान कायम कर। खुदाया कितने ऐसे मरीज हैं जिन्होंने इल्तिमास किया है, खुदाया उनको तो शिफा तो कामिल आजिल अता फरमा। تجھے بیمار کربلا اور بیمار مدینہ بی بی صغرا کا واسطہ دیتے ہیں، ان کو شفا تو کامل عاجل عطا فرما. خدایا تجھے واسطہ دیتے ہیں زینب کبرا کا، جو بے اولاد ہے ان کو تو اولاد صالح عطا کر. خدایا تجھے واسطہ دیتے ہیں بی بی زینب کبرا کا، جو مقروض ہے ان کا قرض غیب سے ادا کرنا. خدایا تجھے اس بی بی کا واسطہ دیتے ہیں جو ان کو صابرہ بھی کہلایا جاتا ہے. خدایا ان کے پاس کتنا صبر تھا، خدایا تو ہمیں بھی توفیق عطا کر کہ ہماری زندگی میں بھی صبر ہو، کیونکہ صبر اور ایمان یہ دو ایسے بال ہیں جو انسان اڑ سکتا ہے اوپر. خدایا ایمان میں اضافہ کر، صبر میں اضافہ کر. اللہم انی اسألک صبرا جمیلا وفرجا قریبا واجرا عظیما. خدایا ہمارے مرحومین کے اوپر رحمتوں کی بارش عطا کر. رسول کا آخری جانشین جو پردہ غیب میں ہے، ان کی ظہور میں تو تعجیل فرما، ان کی ظہور میں تو آسانی فرما. افضل السلام بر محمد و آل محمد.
اعوذ باللہ من الشیطان اللعین الرجیم. بسم اللہ الرحمن الرحیم. Facilitations and congratulations to all the mu'mineen on the birth anniversary of Sayyida Zainab Salamullahi Alayha. I take this opportunity to also thank our respected Sheikh for the enlightening and enriching discussion on the illustrious life of Sayyida Zainab, the qualities of the Aqil, and the examples of the brave. As customary, the three questions after every Hushali programs are as follows, and everyone from young and old are invited to raise their hands. The first question is, what does Zainab mean? Okay, Ali Rza? The beauty, that's the correct answer. Can I request Sheikh Yusuf Ali Durrani? Well done, Ali Rza. The second question is, what does Sharikatul Hussein mean? What's your name? Jafar? What's the answer? The partner of Hussein? That's the correct answer. Salli ala Muhammad. Well done. The final question for tonight is, what is Sayyida Zainab's birth date? Mukhtar? Well done. That's the correct answer.